Assistant Professor, Department of ISC, SJBIT. Program 9, Commission Problem Using Data Flow Testing. Here we shall try to analyze program graph and analyze the number of edges and nodes and try to find out the cyclomatic complexity and tabulate the test cases. Let's have a look.
Program 9, Commission Program, Data Flow Testing. So here we have to implement the commission program and do a white box testing, specifically data flow testing on the commission program. Let us see the logic of commission program. We have declared the variables total log, total stock, total barrel, sales commission, log sales, stock sales, barrel sales, unit price of log, stock and barrel to be 45, 30 and 25. First, we ask the user to enter the number of logs and read it inside a variable called log. While log is not equal to minus 1, we repeatedly read stock and barrel. Every time you read log, stock and barrel, I would compute that into variables total log, total stock and total barrel. And at some point of time, when I want to compute the sales, I would enter log as minus 1, that is sending minus 1 telegram. So once I send minus 1 telegram, that is log is equal to minus 1, next I would print what is the total logs that were sold, total stocks that were sold and total barrels that were sold. Once I have total log, total stock and total barrels sold, I would compute the log sales, stock sales and barrel sales. Log sales would be total logs into log price and likewise for stock sales and barrel sales. Finally, I would compute the sales as log sales plus stock sales plus barrel sales and finally print what is the sales. Next, I would be interested in computing the commission. If sales is greater than 1800, I have to apply 20% of commission, that is 10% on first 1000, 15% on next 800 and 20% on whatever is remaining. Likewise, if sales is greater than 1000, 10% on first 1000 and 15% on whatever is remaining. Lastly, if sales is less than 1000, I have to apply 10% commission. Finally, I would print what is the commission. Let us see the output. Assume I have sold one log, one stock, one barrel. Next, I can sell 69 more logs, 79 stocks and 89 barrel. So totally I have sold 70 logs, that is 69 plus 1, 80 stocks and 90 barrel. Total sales is 7800, commission is 1420. Now we have to check the program using white box testing technique called data flow testing. Let us see what is data flow testing and how to tabulate it. Data flow testing is a test case generation technique where we will list all the variables in our program. So these are the variables in my program. Next, we will be identifying the node where this variable is defined and where it is used. So to do data flow testing, first we should be able to represent the program with line numbers. So for this program, I need to assign line numbers from beginning. So after doing that, so log price is defined at line number 7 and used at line number 24. Likewise, stock price is defined at 8 and used at 25. So while I tabulate that, see total logs, it can be defined at two nodes. It is defined at 10 as well as 16. Also, it is defined at 16, 21 and 24. So in data flow testing, once you identify the defining node and used node, next you should be able to list the path from 7 till 24. Now the same has been done here. So the variables, I am trying to check it for log price, It is defined at 7, used at 24. I will list all the nodes from 7 till 24. So after 7, I can reach 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So, and also I can specify whether this DO path is definition clear or not. If the variable that is lock is not defined along the path anywhere, it is definition clear. What did I mean? If that is the lock variable is defined at 7, and say for some reason I get 7 here again, I'm traversing this 7 here again. So in that case, the variable lock is redefined at 7. So in that case, it will not be definition clear. Like this, we do it for all the variables and for all defining and used node. So if you have 10 and 16, you have to list the path from 10 to 16, again 10 to 21, 10 to 24, next 16 to 16, 16 to 21 and 16 to 24. So once you do it for all, you tabulate like this and then generate the test case that can traverse this path. Hope this gave you an idea of data flow testing. Thank you.